My money don't jiggle jiggle, it folds. I like to see you wiggle wiggle, for sure. It makes me wanna dribble dribble, you know, riding in my Fiat. You really have to see it, 6'2" in a compact, no slack.
Hello everyone, my name's Dean, let's talk crypto. This is where you subscribe for daily Bitcoin updates and technical analysis. We track the price of Bitcoin as a proxy for the cryptocurrency markets at large. Today is March 18th, 2023. And yes, Bitcoin is bullish, but I'm here to tell you, watch out for the altcoins. Altcoins are about to explode. If that interests you, then watch until the very end. We're starting off on the Bitcoin chart, 4-hourly time frame, and you can see, if you don't already know, why Bitcoin is so bullish. Okay, for 55 days, we've been under this resistance right here as designated by this dotted line. And that's essentially our main resistance in the chart. Okay, if you zoom out even more, you can see that this is the neckline of our entire consolidation, our bear market consolidation, as you can see here. Okay. You can see our bear market consolidation, the 250 or so days that we spent absorbing the supply of the bear market drawdown, okay? And after that, what happened? We broke out and retested the bear market consolidation resistance as support. That's called an RS flip. At that moment in time, we officially finished the bear market. Okay, this was the official end of the bear market, okay? You could say that, yes, the markup from the bear market consolidation was the end of the bear market, but officially, the breakout, retest, breakout. You always want to buy the retest. The retest is key. Nothing happens. Nothing is confirmed without the retest. This is the confirmation. So we got that. After this, we came up into this region, which is the neckline of this inverse head and shoulders, which is a bullish reversal pattern, okay? It would be the reversal of this downtrend, right, into a new uptrend, okay? We already kind of established it, as I've said before, but most market participants do not consider this a bull market. They only wait for this, okay? And I've talked about this ad nauseum on the channel. This is wave three. Wave one of the Elliott wave impulse is typically a disbelief rally. Wave two is where the disbelievers say, oh, I told you so. And then wave three is where they all acknowledge, most market participants acknowledge the change of trend, okay? So effectively, this new wave here is the change of trend. This is the wave three, the very violent impulse up. However, this still stands in our way, this resistance, and more importantly, more specifically rather, this resistance, this 55-day resistance. So let's zoom in now. Okay, guys, if you're getting value, please like, share, and subscribe. So if you zoom into the chart, you can see that for the past 55 days, Bitcoin has been rejected by this uptrending diagonal resistance, okay? But finally, yesterday, what happened? We broke it, okay? Again, it's not only about the breakout, it's all about the retest. Remember that. Professionals, intermediate to advanced traders know this. You look for the retest because the retest tells you everything about the nature of the breakout. If you want to avoid a false breakout, you wait for the retest. And here, you didn't just get a retest, you're pretty much hanging out above resistance. As you can see, in the past 55 days, this never happened, right? Every single time we wicked above, we promptly got rejected back below this level. Wicked above, got rejected back below this level. Not so this time, we came above, not wicked, but came above, and now we're hanging out. I know a lot of traders say, well, it's only confirmed once you close a insert time frame, hourly candle, a 4-hourly candle, a daily candle. That is irrelevant. That is completely, please understand, and I didn't know this when I first started, so I'm going to tell you. Please understand, that is completely, there's no rhyme or reason, there's no time frame to confirm anything, okay? It is just something they're choosing. So understand, in technical analysis, there are certain things that are very, you know, cut and dry. Very few, but certain things. But there are other things that it's just, you know, your taste. Some people like the hourly candle confirmation. Some people like the 4-hourly candle confirmation. Some people like the daily. Some people like the weekly. All I'm going to tell you is this. We spent a decent amount of time here. We're kind of hanging out here. This tells me, as a chartist, as an analyst, that price is quite comfortable above this resistance. And if anything, what I'm waiting for is another retest of this 55-day resistance to tell me that, yes, indeed, this is no longer a thing, okay? We did retest it, however, once before, okay? So we broke above and promptly retested it. But is that enough? That's the question now, okay? And I do believe that we will get another retest, because I think that this entire wave is going to be retested like so, okay? It's going to be a 5 waves up, 3 waves down situation. And typical of what we see in weekend trading, it's kind of like wash trading. Why? Only because the DXY, the US dollar, is our underlying asset, and it stops trading on Friday afternoon Eastern Standard Time, starts trading again on Sunday evening Eastern Standard Time. So pretty much anything in between doesn't really have the liquidity to make a major move. So any moves you see happen come back on themselves. So what I believe we're going to see with Bitcoin in the coming hours is a move up to complete this wave five, right? This final wave five. Okay, I don't have a degree for you. So to complete this move, let's just say to complete this move and then come back down and retest this 55-day resistance as support. And that would be a complete reversal of this level right here, because somewhere in here we have 5 waves up, okay, and 3 waves down, right? Because Elliott wave theory, 5 waves up, 3 waves down, 5-wave impulses are always followed by 3 waves or flavors of 3 wave corrections. And that correction comes to between the 382 and the 618 Fibonacci retracement level of the preceding 5 waves. So if I were to take my Fibonacci retracement tool from the bottom to the top, I can expect right here a retest of this region around the golden pocket. You see 0.5 to 618, okay, which is confluent with that 55-day resistance flip to support, okay? Right now, on the lower time frames, I think we're in some sort of complex wave 4 that is likely to pop out. All right, let's turn on our momentum indicators really quickly. You can see that our 15-minute momentum indicator is telling us as much, right? We're going up and down and up and down in a very concerted region, right? We're kind of accumulating, we're consolidating in a tight range, and that's causing our momentum indicators to completely bottom back out. So our momentum indicators don't need much downside price action to bottom back out. That tells you that it's a tight consolidation and it's likely to continue the trend, which is up. Okay, now, I started this video telling you, yes, we know Bitcoin is bullish. We've established that case. If you've watched my live streams, you know how bullish Bitcoin is. And this is just the beginning of something huge. I don't know anybody that's as bullish as me. It's not because I'm really bullish. It's just I'm reading the charts and I'm just saying what my charts are saying. I'm not trying. I don't have a particular agenda. Any number in particular doesn't scare me, or, you know, so many times analysts, traders say, oh, that's unrealistic. Like, you want to take that out of your vocabulary. You want to let your analysis tell you what's realistic and what's not realistic. You know, forget your macro analysis, forget your what you think is big and what you think is small. I think that is a hindrance to your conclusions, right? You want to really ride with your analysis. Anyway, I told you that Bitcoin was bullish, but altcoins are where it's at. Why? Look at this. Bitcoin dominance, for those of you who don't know, Bitcoin dominance is a measure, relative measure of Bitcoin strength within the total cryptocurrency market cap. So if Bitcoin dominance is going up, that means Bitcoin has most of the market capitalization of the entire cryptocurrency market. When Bitcoin dominance goes down, it's the opposite. That means these other coins, these other assets that are not Bitcoin are gaining against Bitcoin in market capitalization. That means they're growing faster than Bitcoin. You see that only in a bull market, okay? You only see sustained loss of Bitcoin dominance in a bull market. And what do we see here? Since 2021, for almost 3 years, Bitcoin dominance has been here. Okay, Bitcoin dominance is not an asset, but the beauty of technical analysis is that you can read anything that's even a derivative of an asset or a group of assets because these chart patterns are universal. So we can see a consolidation for 3 years going up and down in this channel that I've designated, in this blue channel, okay? Up and down and up and down and up and down. I think it's some kind of a triple three, but it doesn't matter. What matters is support and resistance. This is support. This is resistance. The top of the channel, the bottom of the channel. Every time we're at the top, we come down to the bottom. Every time we're at the top, come down to the bottom. What are we doing now? We're at the top. You should expect us coming down to the bottom. And more importantly, it's not just coming to the bottom for the sake of going back to the top, but it's coming down to the bottom to resume this trend, this downtrend that Bitcoin dominance has been in for the longest time. Why is Bitcoin dominance in such a big downtrend? Well, I'm glad you asked. It makes sense, doesn't it? The more the space matures, the more cryptocurrency matures, the more these other non-Bitcoin assets are worthy of market capitalization, are worthy of investment by speculators, by investors, by hedge funds, by governments. Do you understand? The more we develop cryptocurrency, do expect Bitcoin dominance to decrease because these other coins, Ethereum, Cardano, Atom, whatever you want, they also grow in importance and hence grow in market cap. So this also makes sense. Now, the analysis clearly shows that Bitcoin dominance on the daily time frame is at resistance, so it's going to come down, i.e. altcoins are going to gain against Bitcoin. Let's go on a smaller time frame. On the 4-hourly time frame, you can see that this move is almost up, okay? And what I'm looking for is an impulse, because I know as an analyst of that specializes in Elliott Wave theory, that every correction ends in an impulse. Doesn't matter if it's a double three, triple three, or a regular ABC, it ends in an impulse. So this is what I'm seeing here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm seeing that we're pretty much up. When this happens and this goes down, it's alt season officially. Okay. So that's Bitcoin dominance. This is why you should be preparing for an altcoin explosion. Now, the final chart I want to show you is the total crypto market cap, the total two, okay? The total two, which is the entire cryptocurrency market cap all smushed together, put in one chart, minus Bitcoin. So basically, this is all the altcoins, okay? Very interesting chart. Why? Because on the higher time frame, you can clearly see more or less what you see in Bitcoin, that for the past 250 or so days, 300 days, we've been in a massive consolidation. And we talked about this ad nauseum on the channel. You can look at this as a Wyckoff accumulation. You can look at this as 2 degrees of A/B basing and a pivot. But essentially, what you should understand is that after you dump, right, 95, 98%, which altcoins tend to do in a bear market, you have to accumulate all that stuff before marking up. You cannot just turn around and go up. Every single time people dump the price, now we need new buyers to absorb all of that supply at a discounted level. That's the past 250 days, 300 days. This is what we've been doing on my channel. We've just been accumulating, and this accumulation pays off now. Why? Because you can see we're at a major resistance, and not only are we at a major resistance, but we're breaking it. This is where we zoom in. On the 15-minute time frame, you can see that we are indeed above this major resistance, okay? And this was the last rejection in three waves. We know three waves equals correction, okay? And what we did here was We consolidated up and to the right. We went up correctively, came down correctively, and that was all she wrote. Okay, do you recognize something? Yes, I'm sure you do. This is an inverse head and shoulders. This is a bullish reversal pattern. It's only confirmed upon breakout and retest. Okay, retest, again, is crucial. It broke out of the pattern, okay, right here, retested it, and now it's off to the races, okay? Now, question is, are we going to come back and do another retest, right? Perhaps, but all we need to know is that just like Bitcoin, it's hanging out above major resistance, and it's taking its time, okay? Don't be surprised if altcoins do something like this. They go up, come back down, and then continue up. Altcoins will rule the day at this point in time in terms of market capitalization, just in the aggregate, okay? I'm looking at the total too, just because, you know, I don't have time, like in a live stream, to go over every single last altcoin in my watch list and take requests. But what's important, what you should understand, is that now, if ever, is the time to look at altcoins as a serious investment to beat Bitcoin, if you're so inclined, right? If you want major gains, if you want more gains than what you could even get in Bitcoin, then this chart is telling you, invest in altcoins, not financial advice or financial advice. Come and sue me. Come at me, bro. All right. Anyway, guys, I hope this was helpful. I hope this was useful. Like, share, and subscribe. And I will see you on Monday. Take care. Bye. Time for the crime of Les Majeski and the police, because they can't arrest me. I like to see you wiggle. It makes me dribble. Fancy a fiddle? My money don't jiggle, jiggle. It folds. I like to see you wiggle, wiggle. For sure. It makes me want to dribble, dribble. You know, riding in my Fiat, you really have to see it. 6 feet 2 in a compact. No slack.